Here at RevenueCat, we're always looking for new ways to live up to our promise of in-app purchases made easy. And one of the big hurdles to getting started adding in-app purchases and subscriptions into your app is the amount of setup you have to do before you can even test your implementation. Adding the RevenueCat SDK and configuring it in your app's startup is pretty straightforward, but you can't even run a test purchase until you've set up products in App Store Connect or Google Play and then wired everything up. When you make a purchase in the app using the RevenueCat SDK, even in the simulator or debug build, the SDK will call the native in-app purchase flow, which will then call out to the real App Store in a sandbox environment in order to create that fake purchase, which is nice in that it's testing your app fully, but it's a burden to set all of this up before you can even test how your app handles purchases. And if you're using a testing environment separate from the platform simulators, such as Expo Go, which are very popular for different AI-centric vibe coding development, there's no way to test in-app purchases at all. So we built a simple solution we call Test Store to remove the dependency on real stores and streamline the process of testing your app. Test Store simulates everything the real stores do, returning a success or failure, unlocking entitlements, sending webhook events, and of course, sending data into the RevenueCat sandbox. This way, you can test your whole purchase flow without needing to set everything up in App Store Connect or Google Play first. Using the Test Store is incredibly easy. You simply use a Test Store API key in place of the real API key whenever you initialize your RevenueCat SDK in your code. That's it. In the dashboard, you can set up the Test Store products and attach them to offerings exactly like you do with a real store. And paywalls work out of the box exactly like you'd expect. When you make a purchase in your app, instead of using the native in-app purchase dialog, you'll get a purchase dialog that looks like this, where you can choose to simulate a successful purchase, a failed purchase, or a user canceling the purchase altogether. Then you can test that your app handles the newly granted entitlements correctly, or doesn't, in the case of a failure or cancellation. Test Store subscriptions expire on an accelerated timeline to make testing easier. You can find all these details in our Test Store docs. Test Store is also useful for automated UI testing, using the dialog to simulate success, failure, or cancel responses from a purchase. And you can easily switch between the real stores for production builds and the Test Store for your tests by changing which API key is used in your RevenueCat initialization. It's important to note that you'll need to make sure that you're using the real store API key before submitting your app to production, as the Test Store will intentionally fail on release builds to ensure you don't accidentally release it publicly. So check out the Test Store and let us know what you think. You can find all the docs on RevenueCat.com.